Hello and welcome to my next video tutorial. Today I'm going to present to you how to paint white sash and the steel chainmail on the miniature presenting High Elf Archer from Lord of the Rings miniature range. As you can see, the miniature is already in big percentage painted. That's because I already presented to you on my other free tutorial how to paint golden armor and blue rope that is underneath it, this miniature, underneath the armor. And yeah, a few of you asked me to record a video on which I will present how to paint this white sash. I remember from the times when I first started playing and painting miniatures for Lord of the Rings strategy battle game. I remember that painting this detail was uneasy because white color is not easy. It's really easy to paint it as if that would be gray or steel, or like steel enamel. It's a bit problematic. That's why today I'm going to present to you how to do it on my new video. And the first thing I will need to do is that I will paint the sash with black gray. I will use it for both the sash. I imagine that's how you pronounce it. I'm not sure exactly. I had to even ask the community how this thing is called. So forgive me if I pronounce it in the wrong way. I'm doing my best. Okay, so first I need to paint these details with black gray paint, because painting over black is really hard. So it's better to first it's the best idea to first remove all the dust from the miniature, because it spent a lot of time on the shelf. Yeah, so I need to start with this color, because painting with white paint over black base color is hard. Obviously, I make it sometimes, but I make it in different situations when I'm trying to achieve something different. So yeah, paint every detail with this color. I mean, every detail on the sash, of course. Not like everything. I think I will speed up the video at this point a little bit, because well, I'm pretty sure that you all understand what is happening right now. So we can save some time. When I'm painting the chainmail, while this is just the base color, I am trying to avoid painting over the concave details. I'm trying to paint just the convex details, so I'm trying to avoid painting over all the holes in the chainmail. Because we need black color in there in order to create some contrast. Because the miniature is really small, and the smaller the miniature is, the stronger contrast you need to create in order to make details visible. So right now we'll need all the contrast that we can get. Okay, so one of the biggest issues with painting white is that it's easy to make too strong contrast on it, and then it stops to look like it's white. It starts to look like it's some kind of metal, I guess. Okay, so now I will use stone gray. This color is different than other grays because it has yellow tonations in it, and that's why it's perfect for this task, because while you can of course paint white color in many ways, then if you have some steel elements on your miniature, they will be most probably painted with the use of gray colors. So then, when you will have also gray colors on your white elements, then all of this will start to look a bit odd. That's why it's better to use a color that has a bit of different tonations in it. I prefer yellow because white clots, for example, when they are becoming older and older, they are turning into yellowish color. So it's natural that white cotton material will be painted with this type of colors in them, in the shadows. It's the same thing with teeth. Like sometimes famous actors are having artificial teeth, and then they pretty often don't have these yellowish tonations in them. And then because they are actually in the shadows, they are going into gray colors. They can look really unnatural. So I would recommend you to paint white in this way, using yellowish colors. You can also use beige tonations. They will work good as well. And like I mentioned, of course you can use gray, but just look on the whole composition that you are trying to create and think if this will work in the way how you would like it to work. Or if this using gray for white will just make the whole scene look unclear and create unnecessary mess. Okay, this is how it looks like after the first layer. I obviously need to apply a few more, so I will stop the video right now and I will return in a moment when this will be painted. Okay, so this is how the sash looks like after I applied these a few more layers of paint. As you can see here, I painted the convex parts of the sash with this color, and I left a bit of black gray in the deeper parts. I painted it in the same way here. Okay. And now that I have it, I need to introduce you to another color that is very good for painting things like this. And it's silver gray. Very, very, very useful color. As you can see, it's very bright. And now I will start creating finally some shapes on the miniature. Of course, you can make this step using dry brush technique if you prefer. It's up to you. I'm more into having more control over the process of painting, so instead of using dry brush technique, I'm painting with the edge of my brush. As you can see, it works in the same way. Oh, not the same, but very similar way. And now I'm leaving the stone gray, not everywhere, but I will leave it in most of the convex parts of the miniature. While I was now painting with the side of my brush, now I need to have bigger control over it. I just need to see the detail. So I'm painting just now in normal way using the tip of my brush. And now I will make this shape. I don't know how to explain it exactly, but of course, while this is white rope, and I told you that we need to have smaller contrast on it in order to make it look like white and not like some kind of non-metallic, we still need to paint lights and shadows on the details. That's what I meant. So we need to leave stone gray in a few details, not only in concave areas, but also to create the lights and shadows, we need to paint some parts brighter and some parts darker. Of course, as you can see, I need to apply more layers of paint. But I will make them look better off the camera in order to save us some time. as you can see, this is the part where the armor is reflecting the light with very big part of its surface. This means that we should make this sash bright as well, because this is the part that is strongly illuminated by the source of the light. And as you might already know my technique for blendings, when I want to make smooth transition between one color to another, I'm painting with the tip of my brush and I'm gently touching the surface of the paint, of the detail that I'm painting at the moment. And thanks to that, I'm leaving small amount of paint, and this creates smooth transition of colors. As you can see, these details also had a sudden change of plans. It happens sometimes. You need to go with the flow when you are painting, because details might look a bit differently when you start to paint them, and then you can start to feel that this is not the right direction. And you want to change it a little bit, and you should most definitely change it then. And that's what I just did. Of course, it's very, very small difference in my plans. But as you can see, you can already see some shapes, lights and shadows. This is going to look only better and better. Now I'm blending these spaces, just like I explained to you a moment ago. Keep in mind that the final effect will be completed when I use white paint. But it already starts to look a bit like white material to me, white creamy material, and I like these color tonations a lot. Okay, let's go to the details above. Of course, I understand that most of you are painting these miniatures not for the Golden Demon level, because you're just playing with them. And keep in mind that I am a painter, not a gamer. The main reason is that I kept losing. Always, especially again when I was playing against elves. So for me, painting was always more interesting part. I mean, not more interesting, but I really, really enjoyed and still enjoy painting. And so I am of course presenting to you how to paint on on a really high level, and nobody, especially me, expects from you that you will paint your whole army like this, because this is time consuming. But it doesn't mean that you cannot benefit from watching this video and learning the techniques, because what is most important is about painting is placing the lights and shadows in the right positions. Then your miniatures look natural and just good, impressive. And you can later apply these rules that you learn from here and simply spend much less time on creating smooth transitions on the miniature, make it all rough, and then still on the battlefield, because you won't look on your miniatures from such small distance like now, and on the battlefield they will look great if you just quickly place the lights and shadows in the right places. Okay, now the other side. If you have problems with seeing which detail is concave and which is convex, you can first of all do this. Just move gently through the surface with the side of your brush. You're making basically dry brush technique right now, but with not destroyed brush. Okay, and you can, and if not that, you can just move your miniature around to see it on different angles, then light and shadow will present you which details are where, because sometimes they are not very well visible. Okay, so now I'm obviously leaving the stone gray in the concaved areas. Okay, so this is how it looks like now. Okay, so as you can see, I changed just a few things. Basically, almost nothing. So I could not stop the video as well. Now we can finally go to the tool. white paint to the white paint. I'm sorry, but these things are always confusing me. Because yeah, I'm going to use white, finally. But with white, you need to be always careful. No matter what you are painting, use it just for creating reflections on the surface. So yeah, like I mentioned before, it's a really small miniature, so we will paint most of the edges with it in order to make them visible. More visible, of course. Once again, when you are painting edges, it's good to use edge as well. Not always. It all depends on the shape of the detail that you are painting. But keep this in mind. Okay, I will leave it a little bit darker on the bottom. Okay, I ruined the effect in here. Oh, but the scale is so small that it won't probably be visible. My movements right now are the same if I would be drawing something with a pencil. So I'm trying to leave small marks on the surface. That's why it seems to be already blended. Okay, once again, keep in mind the fact that if the reflections on the armor are located in here, then the sash supposedly should be brighter in here as well. I will make this part a little bit brighter. Okay. So now obviously I'm going into marking smaller parts of the sash. Of course, I'm trying to leave a bit of previous layers on the sides of these new lines. Thanks to that, I'm creating transition. And because the miniature is so small, I think you won't need to make anything else. It just goes. It looks pretty smooth. I think that, well, I would make it smoother, but I think it looks really good. I mean, the transition between the white color and the shadows, it starts to look really, really good. Now, once again, I'm trying to leave, not everywhere, but in many situations, I'm trying to leave the previous color, the silver gray, between, leave a little bit of it visible. I think that what I'm presenting to you is saying for itself. Much better than what I'm trying to explain. So just look what I'm doing. Of course, if you are using different paint brand than I do, keep in mind that, like I mentioned before, the most important thing is to place lights and shadows in the right places. And if you're going to use a bit different color on your material because you're using other brand, it's not really important. It will always look good if you place lights and shadows in the right places. And I'm using Vallejo just because I got used to them and I'm just comfortable with them. While I used Citadels for many years and I had fun with them, when I started to use wet palette, they became a bit problematic for applying on my wet palette. So I stick to Vallejo. Okay, so this is how this white sash looks like now. As you can see, I think that it looks good. Of course, I would make a few changes if I would be painting this like for other purposes than tutorial, but I wanted to present to you how to paint white and I think that it looks good. Now let's make the chainmail, because I promised you to do that as well. Okay, this is going to be much quicker, I believe. Okay, so first neutral gray. And I'm going to once again okay, I could enlarge it a little bit. Can we? No. That's all I can get. I'm sorry I tried. Okay, so now I'm once again trying to look on these shapes and paint the shapes of the rings that are creating the chainmail. And try to paint just them. Don't try to pour your paint all over this, because when you are covering holes, it stops to look like a chainmail. It starts to look like nothing. Like one big gray or silver blob. It's better to don't cover a few details with gray color than to paint over this whole black holes in the rings. Because these black holes and these black elements, when it comes to painting, are creating the effect of reflections. So they have to be in there in order to create realistic metal effect. So as you can see, now the holes in the chainmail are most definitely visible. So now I'm going to use another color. This color is blue-gray pale. I'm going to highlight a few of these details that are now much more visible. I will paint most of them, but I will keep a few of the details painted just a few moments ago in the areas that are more shaded. Enough. Okay, and now the final reflections, and for making them I highly recommend you to use not your brush but this type of tool. It's called Color or Clair Shaper. It's all up to the store where you get it. It's just a brush with a rubber tip, and well, use it instead of your brush, because if you are mixing your paints with your brush, you're killing it. Okay, now as you can see, the mixing goes really smoothly and your brush is much happier. Okay, this is going to be really quick now because I need to paint just a few reflections on the chainmail. So highlight now just these details that should be the brightest. Darker parts like below the elbow painted with neutral gray. Leave of course previous colors here and there, because the more colors and tonations we have, the more realistic the painting looks like. Looks, I guess. Okay, and that's it. Okay. So, in conclusion, I presented to you today... Of course, the wrong button. It's always the wrong button. Okay, so in conclusion, I presented to you today how to paint the white sash on the Elf Archer from the strategy battle game and the chainmail on his arms. The chainmail of course was much quicker and easier, so just keep in mind that when you're painting chainmail, you're just painting a few reflections. Keep black holes black, a few things darker, and just paint a few reflections. You could most probably even skip the step with the blue-gray pale color and just go straight to the main reflections, but I like to use more tonations in between. So I hope that everything that I presented to you today was easy to understand, that you will use this knowledge, and I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel and see you on the next one. Bye!